Like and subscribe right now, or you're going to have bad luck for the rest of the week.
Some animals just aren't easy to spot. Have you ever tried finding your golden retriever dog in a field of grain? If you have, you know the difficulty of finding an animal that fits perfectly in with its surroundings. Today, we are talking about exactly those animals and the ones that are on the brink of extinction, which are sadly also getting harder to find. Let's take a look at them. Number 10, the shoebill stork. Many people that see a picture of this bird find they look quite terrifying and not very friendly at all. One of the most fascinating things about the shoe-billed stork is the way it moves, so get ready for some scary facts. This bird is also able to stand perfectly still for hours on end, while winning a staring contest against anybody that would be foolish enough to try. Thankfully for us, the bird eats mainly fish, frogs, water snakes, and the occasional turtle or rodent. If their preferred kind of fish was unlucky enough to swim past them, they would snap forward and catch it with ease, and you wouldn't like to mess with something that can react as fast as the shoe-billed stork. This species is considered vulnerable on the conservation status scale, and isn't a species you see very often. If you'd like to go bird watching for this specific one, you'd need to travel to eastern Africa, and especially the wetlands near the Nile. However, I wouldn't advise against this, as you would also find snakes, crocodiles, and aggressive hippos. Number 9. The pangolin. The reason the pangolin isn't often seen has multiple reasons. For one, the pangolin is overall an endangered species, and some of them are counted as a critically endangered, making them hard to spot in the wild naturally, as there aren't many of them left. The reason they're endangered can be accounted to deforestation and overhunting. Pangolins are hunted for their meat, which is often used in traditional medicines and fashion accessories, particularly in China and Vietnam. There is a constantly large trading market going on for Asian pangolins, which is illegal but doesn't stop humans from killing and selling them for the thousands of pangolins every year. The other reason is they aren't often spotted in the wild, as they are rather shy animals and would more than likely hide when seeing a human in the distance. And after all that information, they have a good reason to do so, don't you think? Number 8. The Sakaya white deer. This deer is explicitly native to the Sakarian Army Depot in the Sakaya country, where they live in a fenced-off area that's exclusively reserved for the US Army. The herd of deer has roughly 900 individual animals, making it the largest deer herd known to man. However, only 300 of these deer are white, and scientists are not really sure how this came about. One theory is that their genes just mutated. Other theories are a bit more otherworldly. For example, that radiation caused their color, or that they are an army experiment gone wrong. In Austria, white stags are mythical beings that are considered to be holy. In folklore, they are immortal and often wear something like a halo between their antlers. Any person who's lucky enough to come across such a being is blessed with life without sadness, but they usually show themselves to be only humans with flaws. That's why hunters in that area often have paintings of such beings in their cabin. It serves as a reminder that hunting should never be about killing for sport or personal amusement. Number 7. The elephant shrew. This little animal is just one big contradiction. The elephant shrew is not actually classified into the shrew family, and scientists have found that this species is more closely related to elephants than they are actual shrews. Don't be fooled by its size though. The elephant shrew has nothing but the amazing qualities of its own, without having to compare them to any other animal in the first place. For example, this shrew can survive all kinds of habitats, from jungles to forests, plains, and mountains. This little guy can make a home and living basically anywhere if it would like to. So with the elephant shrew living almost anywhere on the globe, how come it's ever rarely seen? Well, for starters, this mammal isn't all too big and measures only 10 to 30 centimeters in length, so you should probably just miss them even if you were right in front of your nose. Not only that, but it's also considered to be one of the fastest small mammals alive. It can reach speeds up to 28.8 kilometers per hour, which is roughly 17.9 miles per hour. Number 6. The Northern Hairy-Nosed Wombat. Northern Hairy-Nosed Wombat sure has a mouthful of a name, doesn't it? With a name like this, you just know it's going to be a fun little animal to talk about, and indeed, this wombat belongs to the cuter side of animals we are looking at today. This makes it sadder to be known that these little guys are on the critically endangered rank in the conservation status. Originally, there were two groups of wombats, which were split up by the Spender Gulf in Australia. Some of the reasons for their declining numbers are the spread of rabbits and the actions of landowners. Other reasons are wildfires, droughts, floods, and habitat loss, so these wombats are almost in constant danger. Thankfully, humanity has decided to step in and has been making steady progress to secure the population. The wombat has received increasing attention and funds, which was given for wombat research, population monitoring, fire management, maintenance of predator-proof fences, and elimination of invasive plant species. Let's hope we can save this cute little guy so we can see them in person one day. Number 5. The Yangtze's Finless Porpoise. While this porpoise may not be completely finless, it was named after the missing fin on its back, which by the way is called the dorsal fin, just in case you want to impress your friends next time you talk to them about underwater animals. What is sad about these cute creatures is they are only roughly 1,020 12 of them left, and they are in constant danger of going extinct. To be exact, it is assumed that there is about 86.06 chance that it will go extinct within the next 100 years. The reason for their population decline is the lack of food, pollution, and ship movements on the Yangtze River. As a result, few people are able to find this creature in their natural habitat. Thankfully, there are some individuals left in zoos around the world, and attempts are being made to secure the population of the finless porpoise. We still have pictures and videos of these elegant creatures to look at, which will come in handy because it's nearly impossible to find them out in the wild. Number 4. The Pygmy Three-Toed Sloth. I'm not sure what it is about sloths, but they always look so lovable and endearing. Am I right? Maybe. It's just the slow and lazy way it lives, which many people can relate to. Or maybe it's simply the reason they always seem like they have a small smile on their face. It's also possible that I am looking into it too much, and that sloths are simply adorable, and that there is nothing else to it. This sloth is native to only a small island off the coast of Panama, which also has a name quite hard to pronounce for anyone that isn't from around there, and is everything a sloth could hope for. Places to sleep, things to eat, trees to climb. The sloth lives a simple life after all. Unfortunately, this animal, just like some others on our list, is considered to be critically endangered. Threats to the sloth's survival include timber harvesting, human settlement among other things, and in 2011, a study showed that there were only 79 pygmy sloths in the wild left. Number 2. The Hooded Grebe. Many are familiar with the hooded grebe as they might have seen it in multiple nature documentaries. Their graceful mating dance is often seen in these shows, making them pretty recognizable. They are also easily recognized by their black and white feathers and red eyes. What many don't know is that they have been around for much longer, long before any nature documentary was even a concept. These birds have been around for roughly 35 million years, which is a long time to be existing on Earth. The hooded grebe can usually be found in southern Argentina. That's as if it can be found at all. There are only an estimated 800 to 1,000 birds left in the world, which ranks them as critically endangered on the conservation status scale. The reason for their dramatic decline in numbers is not just a single one. When the first American minks were first introduced to the Buenos Aires Plateau, they killed more than half of the adult grebes in one colony. Other reasons are climate change and excessive grazing by sheep, which limits the growth of vegetation. Number 2. Pineapple Eagle. There's a small contradiction that we would like to address here. The eagle may be on the list of wild animals, but they're rarely ever seen. But this bird is actually the biggest bird on Earth regarding its length and wingspan. So how could the biggest bird on Earth ever stay out of sight if he is the biggest of his species? Well, the reason is that this bird is on the list has nothing to do with its size, but rather deforestation. Humans have cleared so much of an area in which this bird has lived in that it leads to a sharp decline in numbers, making it almost impossible nowadays to spot this bird in the wild. Originally, the bird was called the monkey-eating eagle, as it was believed that this species exclusively fed on monkeys. After a while, it was proven that this wasn't really the case. From small bats to medium-sized European deer, anything can be prey for this mega bird. For context, the eagle usually weighs anywhere between 4 to 8 kilograms, and the deer may weigh 14 kilograms. Now that is a pretty scary thought. Number 1. The Southern Darwin's Frog. You can take a guess at who was the first person to discover the Darwin's Frog. Any guesses? Of course, it was named after the famous Charles Darwin, which he found in the Chile on his famous world voyage on the HMS Beagle. When it was first described in 1841 by a man named André Marie Constant de Mirel and his assistant Gabriel Bribon, they gave it the name Darwin's Frog. Now make no mistake, Drimmel was not known. Now, make no mistake, Drimmel was not the one who found it and decided to name it after Darwin as an honor. Darwin had found this animal originally and had not much further description of the animal. The reason this animal is so different from other frogs is that his unique camouflage system to deal with predators. This frog has a nose that resembles a leaf and its colors that fit its description too. When it's brown and green body, the Darwin's Frog can fit perfectly into natural habitats. When threatened, it will lay on the ground and look like a dead leaf, which is incredibly effective against predators. Though combined with its rather small numbers of this particular species, the playing dead as a leaf makes them hard to ever see in person, as you would just mistake them for some foliage. That's all for today's video. Thank you for watching. While you're here, go ahead and click one of the two videos on your screen. See you there.